Welcome to this video on day trading for beginners. And actually, this is a great technique for anyone, a great day trading strategy that anyone can use for day trading stocks, the futures, the E-minis especially. I've got the E-minis up here, but it's a very basic technique, and that's why I call it day trading for beginners today. So first of all, notice that at the beginning of the day, this is the beginning of the open here, we have a gap open. The E-minis, S&P E-minis, go up a little bit. Okay, so they go up for about, 15, 20 minutes or so. Now, what we're going to do is compare that with the advanced decline. Now, the advanced decline index, that may be the symbol, or it may not be the symbol that is used for your data provider. I'm using Kinetic Data here, so that's the symbol for Kinetic Data. And then I've got a 20-period simple moving average, and I've got two-minute charts, as you can see. Now, the advanced decline is not an indicator. That's the first thing I want to say. To avoid any confusion, this is not something you can go in your indicators and find in your list of indicators. It is an index. So it has a symbol. So just like a stock, for example, or a futures contract will have a symbol. And in this case, since we have the E-minis here, it's ES. And then the expiration date, which at the time that I'm doing this video is December of 2016. So that's the symbol. Okay, Microsoft symbol, MSFT. And that's its symbol. So it's the same thing here. This is not an indicator. It is actually an index that measures a statistic of the number of advancing issues versus declining issues. And issues means basically equities or stocks. So how many are going up versus how many are going down at that time? And it is something that I use a couple of different ways. So first, let me show you the first way that I use it. And that is like this. So we have the E-minis coming up at the open. But if you look at the advanced decline index, it is not going up. Does not make a higher high, whereas the E-mini does. That's a warning to me saying, oh, wait a minute. We got a temporary little move up here on the E-minis, but I'm not going to trust that. This is contradicting the advanced decline index, and therefore, this tends to be more correct than the individual stock or futures contract that you're trading. And so I'm normally looking for this to win out between the two of them. This is going sideways, and this one's going up. So looking to take this short. Now, let me say one other thing here before we get carried away with this. This is not something that you use alone. In fact, there's nothing that you use alone, nothing you use in isolation. It would be part of your trading methodology, one part of your trading methodology. All right, so let's get that very clear. All right, so let's look at another way that we use this. Actually, it's the same way, but we'll look at it from a different perspective. All right, so here we have a similar situation. I suppose you could call this a divergence, but the advanced decline line goes up here. But look, again, we have a higher high on the E-minis, whereas we have just equal high, essentially, on the advanced decline. And so therefore, again, that's showing that this move up is moving up on weakness. Sometimes we call these internal indicators. They're measuring what's going on internally in the market. And so therefore I would say, okay, if I was long here, I'd be thinking, oh, you know what? I think I'll just get out. And if I have other indications, other reasons to go short, I may actually even go short and be able to get in early. So that's the number one way to use it, is these divergences. So here's the second way that I use this. Here's the 20-period simple moving average. And I put it on the E-minis now. So we have a 20-period moving average on both of them. Here's what's interesting. The idea is basically to trade in the direction of the 20-period simple moving average on the advanced decline index. So for example, let's compare here and here. Well, first of all, this, a lot of times they'll be the same. So here we're the price action's below the 20-period simple moving average and price is moving down, and we get an identical move here. Okay, that's great. Now, here's where we get something different though. So here, if you look at this section, on the E-minis, price gets below the 20-period simple moving average, but not so on the advanced decline line, or advanced decline index, if you will. It stays above it. So now we're using, we still get a higher low here as we do here, but relative to the moving average, it stays above it. So basically we're looking to go long when the advanced decline line is above the 20 SMA and short when it gets below it. And we also are looking at the angle. So we're able to stay in to this all the way to right here where it crosses below it. And look what kind of reward that gives you. Now, if you waited and took, if you got out when the 20 period moving average is broken by the E-minis, then that happens here. But it doesn't happen on the advanced decline line. It stays above it, or it touches it and holds it as support, holds as support. And here for the first time, it gets below it. So you're able to get a little extra profit out of it. Sometimes it's a lot more profit. Sometimes it's just a little bit. But it's another way you can use a trailing stop, in other words. Works great for a trailing stop. So if you like this video and you got some benefit from it, understand that, sure, it's free, but if you got value from it, you actually then have a moral obligation to pay it forward. And you can do that by clicking the little share button below and share it on social media with your friends and your acquaintances. And you know what? It actually feels really good to click that button. You're going to get a warm feeling in your heart, believe me. Now, if you're watching this on YouTube, also, I encourage you to click the thumbs up icon below and leave a comment. That really encourages me to create more free tutorials for you. Now, here's something very, very special. I'm giving away one of my favorite trade strategies. I call it the rubber band trade. It has a very high win-loss ratio. I'm going to teach you how to trade this absolutely free. It's a simple trade. I can teach it in about 26 short minutes, and you can get the video explaining that trade strategy absolutely free by clicking on the image in the top left corner, or if you're on a mobile device, click on that little I with a circle around it in the top right corner of this video. And if you're not watching on YouTube, then there's probably a link below or an opt-in form on the side. Once you do that, I will personally email the video to you with the rubber band trade strategy.